This week on Outdoor Bound TV, we get a chance to get an up-close and personal look at one of the oldest surviving traditions that families have been practicing here in the Upper Midwest for hundreds of years, the production of maple syrup. Then we head further north to the forest of Manitoba, Canada, for a spring black bear hunt with a young man and his father that have a very special bond.
What a fish.
There we go.
Can you believe that? It's just fantastic.
Outdoor Bound TV is brought to you by Mission by Matthews and Vortex Optics.
I'm going to be just like my dad. Strong like him, smart like him. And now that I have my mission menace, I'm going to be a bow hunter just like he is. This bow is my beginning, my future. This is my mission.
Featuring an advanced perimeter weighted dual cam system, the Mission Menace provides power for the hunt and adjustability to fit any beginner, young or old. Visit missionarchery.com to find an authorized retailer near you. Mission by Matthews.
Markham's new pocket-sized handheld underwater cameras, the Recon 5 and 5 Plus, use a 5-inch color display to deliver superior screen detail and employ a combination of dark water LED and infrared lighting to punch through the darkness. The Recon 5 Plus adds a built-in DVR and on-screen display for critical information, previously only available on full-sized underwater viewing systems. This winter, see what you've been missing with a Recon from Markham Technologies, the undisputed leader in underwater cameras.
The new Acme Rattlemaster has a built-in echo chamber with a brass rattle that calls fish in. The body's solid brass too and won't bend or dull, and reflects fish-attracting light all over the water column. This 1-2 punch of sight and sound means you drill less holes because fish come to you. Jig it, rip it, or shake it for crappie, walleye, northern salmon, or trout, and experience multi-species action with just one bait.
Hi everyone, welcome to Outdoor Bound TV. I'm Kurt Walbeck. You know, each week many of us enjoy one of nature's delicacies without ever thinking where it comes from or how much work it takes to produce it. On this week's show, we head to northern Wisconsin, where five generations of the Holley family have been producing maple syrup.
The farm is about 220 acres. It was homesteaded in 1883 and has gone through the generations. I'll be the fifth generation maple syrup producer. I was born in Pottstown, Pennsylvania, and my dad was born and raised on the farm, so we'd come up every spring break and every Easter to help out my grandfather. And then when I went to school, then mom and dad retired, I started helping them. And that's just how involved. And when they have me and have fresh legs, obviously we can tap more trees. But mainly it's about four or five people. It's my mom, my dad, me, my wife, and a couple neighbors that really help out the most. We usually tap mid-March, but it's varied. Some years we've tapped early as March 7th. Last year we didn't tap until March 23rd. Last March, we didn't collect a gallon of sap till almost April. This March, we're well on our way, we're about 3/4 or so done with the season. And we tap about 730-ish trees, give or take one or two. and we always try to tap hard maple. And the reason why we tap hard maple is because they have a higher sugar content than soft maple.
The tree has to be about 40 years old, and you just take a simple drill bit, and you want to kind of tap where at a little upper angle. You want to look for old tap holes. There's an old tap hole there. It doesn't hurt the tree at all. You're just taking the extra sap as long as you don't put on too many pails. So you don't want to go in the same tap hole. You just want to create a new hole. Knock off a little bit of the bark.
My great-grandfather started making syrup. I mean, they used drill bits and screwed it in like this. I mean, that's painful. Now people can use chainsaws or use cordless drills, which we use. He had flat bottom pans, weren't very efficient at all. Now we have much more, you know, fire efficient evaporators, you know. So the process is getting better, but it's still the same raw product, and that's the sap. My grandfather, he probably tapped more than 20, 30 trees. It took him a long time to tap 20, 30 trees and to boil it all down. And now we're, you know, 700 or so, and that's it. There's some guys that can tap hundreds of thousands of trees. No, we're keeping the family, and it's staying at about 730. You had a long, cold, you know, brutal winter. What are you gonna do now? Let's get outside, let's do something. It's usually sunny, 50 degrees, walking around the woods. It's something to do. And that's why I think I like to do it so much, because it's something to do. The optimal conditions are 25 at night, has to freeze every night and get to about 45 degrees or a little bit warmer during the day. A nice light west, northwest breeze is the best. And I've always said it's very difficult to make your largest agriculture product in March or April because the months are so crazy. Every year, there's always an agriculture challenge. Last year it was snow, this year it was mud. It does help being a meteorologist, it does help being a weatherman. Dad always says it's up to me when we tap, so I do look at the long range model. There's a lot of other maple syrup producers in the area, so I try to give them little bits of advice, when to tap, when not to tap, when I think the peak run will be, and then when I think it's over. And once you see a couple days, 74, 75, it's over. One year, like 2012, it was one of the worst years. We had 80 degrees for 4 or 5 days. Horrible syrup season. 2013, 2014, we had cool springs. We had cold March and a cold April, and it just ran like crazy. It's very difficult to hit peak run, but historically, looking at all the calendars, last week of March, first week of April, and I usually try to give the guys back at the station about a week heads up. But as long as I give them a week heads up, they're more than happy to fill in for me. As long as I give them a little syrup, and I usually do.
My name is Robert Holley, and this is my lovely wife, Mary Holley, and we've been married for 36 years. Originally, we just tapped like 100 trees, a couple hundred trees, and now we're up to 700 trees with the new evaporator that we bought. My grandfather made it, and then my great-grandfather made it, my grandparents made it, my father made it, and so I've been making maple syrup all my life. And it's just the time of year, you have to do it. It's just one of those things that kind of gets in your blood, I guess, and you just can't wait to tap those trees, and then you can't wait till it's over either, because it's a lot of work.
I never tasted pure maple syrup until I tasted it here. So that puts me in my early 30s. And I don't have it in my DNA, as Bob does, and as our son Mark does. But I've learned to love everything about this farm, and I'm blessed to be part of it. It just makes me feel great to be part of something that is so unique. I don't know how many people have actually made maple syrup, but it's a huge amount of work. It truly is. Why does it cost so much? I mean, who wants to pay $50 a gallon for maple syrup? Why is it so expensive, Bob?
Because it's a huge amount of work.
There you go.
Takes a lot of time, a lot of effort.
This is our new evaporator. We got it from Vermont, and everything is gravity flow. It starts up in this tank, in this milk tank. It's a 400-gallon milk tank, which is now a sap tank. It's clear sugar water. It's a homogeneous mixture. It has a little sweet flavor to it at best. So it comes in clear, just like water that drips out of your faucet. And then it gravity flows into the back pan, and there are really deep grooves in there. And then you have all the flames that are down here, if you can kind of picture that. So it starts in here. The gravity kind of forces its way to here, and then it finishes in the front pan, or known as the finishing pan. And the general rule of thumb is about 40 to 1. So 40 gallons of water or sap to 1 gallon of syrup.
The final test is with the hydrometer. Check out your specific gravity on it to see if it's syrup or not. If it's a little too done, it can candy in the jars. If it's not done enough, well, then it's just not right. It's not the right product that you want to sell.
Water boils on a given day at 212, and that will alternate depending on the weather, elevation, and a few other factors. But when it boils at 7 degrees above water, so around 219, and then it comes off and it comes out of here and it drips into that pail as syrup.
We use plastic jugs that we buy from the distributors and bottle it up down here in the shed and then market it for sale. I look at some of the old pictures and I look at, you know, they used to do it out in the woods with just a wide open evaporator, and there's one spot in the woods where they used to set it up. We call it where the old boiler used to be, and there's just flat rocks. It's set on flat rocks, and it makes you appreciate how things have gone from generation to generation to generation. Here we are in a nice building with a concrete floor and heat and, you know, and everything.
Lights.
It's a little bit different than what they did. And sometimes you just sit and reminisce and think about, you know, how they did it. They didn't have the boots we have or the clothes we have. So it makes you appreciate it, but also makes you feel good that you know that you're continuing doing what they did and pass it on and on and on. Hopefully it'll go on to the next generation and so on and so forth.
Seeing our son take over, I mean, I think you can observe that Mark is now bearing the brunt of the heavy work. And it just makes me feel so good. It really does. I'm excited to be part of it.
Outdoor Bound TV is brought to you by Real Deal Mineral and HHA Sports. Deal G2 seeds. The results speak for themselves.
Nisbets. Durable, effective, unique.
The must-have fishing lures for every musky angler. Crank it, rip it, fast or slow. Our flagship Livid Fish brings them in again and again. Put trophy musky in your boat with Naze baits. Go topwater with our 10 head. From deadly slow to an all-out sprint. Naze baits. Get it done. Check us out online or pick up Naze baits at a retailer near you.
Proving yet again that the best never rest, Otter introduces Otter Thermaltech, the proprietary full thermal shell found on every 2015 Otter shelter. Beginning with the all-new XDH hub shelters and the all-new lightweight one-man XD hideout, on up to the ever-popular XD and XD Pro Series shelters that have earned a near-legendary reputation for unmatched toughness and durability. At Otter, we know stopping at good enough is way overrated. This ice season, see for yourself how the best just keep getting better.
Value Implements serves all of West Central Wisconsin and knows more stores plus more selection equals more value. And value means providing our customers with a wide variety of quality Kubota products. Value means providing outstanding Kubota product knowledge and customer service. Value means providing the largest selection of Kubota products at 6 convenient locations. Value Implement.
More stores, more selection, more value.
You know, each year we receive thousands of photos from our viewers of animals that you've harvested and fish that you've caught, and we love to share them with you here on the show. And this year you can win some great prizes once again just for sending us your photos.
All you have to do to be eligible to win is email us your photo or share it with us on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter.
Prizes include an assortment of musky lures from Naze Baits, a Yeti cooler from Petrick Service Station, a trip for two aboard the Grand Illusion 2 charter boat on Lake Michigan. And this year's grand prize, a 4-day, 3-night fishing vacation at Sunset Cove Resort on Lake of the Woods, Ontario.
And remember, all you have to do to be eligible to win is send us your photo with your name and your hometown.
Here are this week's Outdoor Bound TV viewer photos.
Hey everyone, welcome back. Next, we head to the Snow Lake region of Manitoba for a spring black bear hunt with a father and son from eastern Wisconsin. Now, I think you'll figure out really quick that these two have a pretty unique relationship. Let's head to beautiful Wekusko Falls Lodge right now.
I'm Walt Janke from Hortonville, Wisconsin, and we're here in Snow Lake, Manitoba, Wekusko Falls Lodge. I think I've harvested 6, maybe 7 bears here. Muzzleloader, archery, rifle, little everything. I've had a lot of fun. But we had an opportunity, we meaning my son and myself, we were invited by Mark Snyder through the SCI chapter Northeast Wisconsin, and we wanted to come up here on a bear hunt, but not for me. For my son Paul. Been slowly introducing Paul to the outdoors. He's 25 years old now, and he's taken to it. He's harvested a number of animals. He's taken a Russian boar. He's shot a couple of 3 whitetails. A nice elk, which he reminds me about almost daily because it's a little bit bigger than mine. He'll tell you that too. Normally at this time of year, he is involved in Special Olympics. He enjoys track, and he would be at the state track meet, but he decided to go bear hunting instead. So here we are. Obviously, I was going to chaperone him because Paul needs a little assistance when he's out there. So we made some special arrangements with Brian and Alyssa, the owners of Wekusko Falls, and right from the start, they were very accommodating. Very reassuring that things were going to be handled well, and they were. He had sent me updated photos of what he calls a cage, where he puts his hunters in when you hunt on the ground versus in a a tree stand. But basically it was a steel frame with fencing, and it looked like a dog cage, but very protective, and they're very, very cautious with their hunters, and that turned out to be a good thing. So we stayed in contact, walked us through, let them know my concerns, the challenges we were dealing with, and they helped us every way through the process. So really, when we left Hortonville, I was quite confident that business was going to be taken care of very well. That was not at all a concern. So we went in a little bit earlier because Brian had checked the bait earlier in the day, and he walked in on a nice bear, a nice black bear that he said is worth taking. He thought it was a new bear to the bait site. And within the hour, we had bear activity. So here we are. We came up and we got out. We had a chocolate sow with three cubs, and it got very interesting. We had just gotten our peanut butter and jelly sandwiches out, and honestly, those bears could smell those peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. So that's, I think, what they were after. We had mother sow and her three cubs, which decided to not only try to get in our cage, they were putting their nose in between the chain linking. So we're watching these four bears, and what happens, we could see another bear coming in the distance, of which that bear ran off mom and three cubs. Things settled down a little bit, and we knew immediately that was a bear that we were going to take, but we had to get the right shot, the right angle. We didn't want to shoot it laying down or standing the wrong direction, so.
That's awesome, buddy.
Yep.
We'll give him some time and then we'll go see what we can find, okay?
Okay. Yep.
Alrighty.
We did the follow-up and we very quickly could see it laying there, but we left Paul in suspense a little bit in not telling him that bear was expired. I said, you know, just nudge him a little bit. And I said, if he doesn't wiggle, you know you got him. And hey, it was an awesome moment.
This is my first time black bear hunting. I get it lined up through the crosshairs, and he takes the safe shot. My heart was going like this, pounding. I started breathing real heavy.
Thank you, Brian. You betcha, buddy. That's an honor. And you got one gorgeous bear.
Yeah, I know. My mom's going to be happy for me.
You know, this was Paul's first trip out of the country. He really had no idea what to expect. I think he almost thought we were going turkey hunting or whitetail hunting in Wisconsin. And obviously this is quite different. That bear weighed 161 pounds. In Paul's mind, it weighed 1,061 pounds. He shot a world record in his mind. And that's all that matters. We had a little time together when I was skinning and quartering the animal. So he says, Dad, he says, you're the best dad in the world. And I said, well, Paul, I can beat that. You're the best son in the world.
Outdoor Bound TV is brought to you by Brewpub Pizza and Nays Bates.
Brewpub Pizza is specifically designed with the hungry in mind. It's big, it's bold, and it's outrageously delicious. Brewpub Lotsa Matzo Pizza is made with your favorite premium meats and veggies topped with over a half pound of real Wisconsin mozzarella cheese. When you're looking for the ultimate pizza adventure, when you crave a really serious pizza that brings the great Brewpub experience, this is the one. Pick it up today at your favorite local grocer. Brewpub Lotsa Matzo Pizza, the ingredients for a great time.
We handle your races, your jumps, and your trails. Isn't it time you give your daily driver the same love? AMSOIL Signature Series Synthetic Motor Oil delivers 75% more engine protection against horsepower loss and wear than required by a leading industry standard. AMSOIL also offers a full family of snowmobile lubricants, giving you above and beyond fortification for your weekday and weekend vehicles.
Order direct online at qcamsoil.myamsoil.com.
Markham Technologies unleashes GPS with the release of the RT9, the first to combine sonar, underwater camera, and navionics mapping in a 9-inch ruggedized touchscreen tablet. Built on the Android operating system, the Wi-Fi-enabled RT9 can be used as a standalone tablet or snap into the cradle or performance pack for unmatched portability. Ice Electronics, the way they were meant to be. Sonar, GPS, underwater camera, one unit. Experience the RT9 from Markham Technologies.
Nearly 70 years ago, a simple idea was taking form in the heart of the Ice Belt. That idea was, if you combined a commitment to quality with a passion for the sport of ice fishing, you could build a better ice auger. From that idea, StrikeMaster was born. Forever committed to innovation in the quest to build a lighter, more durable auger. StrikeMaster. Powerful. Durable. Reliable.
Outdoor Bound TV is brought to you by the W.C. Russell Moccasin Company and Golden Hawk Canoes.
Hey, Paul, congratulations on your Manitoba Black Bear, and thanks for allowing us to tag along on your trip. And we hope that you'll join us again here next week when we'll bring you more great hunting and fishing action from around the Midwest, around the nation, and around the world, right here on Outdoor Bound TV.
Sound check, we good? Did I move my microphone? Okay.
Peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Don't go away mad, just go away.
This past January, I did an elk hunt, 6x6, bigger than my dad's. This was a 5x5.
Did you get that bug flying up my nostril?